Welcome back to my channel. It's me, Norman Reed. Today I'm just gonna do a quick haircut and style of my hair. Right now I have it in a puff. Let me just take it out real quick and show you like what I'm working with. Working with this shit right here. It's kind of going crazy right now. I think it has like a life of its own, but I'm gonna try to resurrect my look. I'm gonna try to do twists on my hair. We're just only using two products, which is just using a curl cream and some castor oil to just make my hair lay down, because I can't wear any fitteds right now, and that's making me and the homeboys real sad. But before I jump into this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, leave a like down below, and comment or watch this video, or like, do you think this look is gonna be a success or not? But with that being said, let's get into it. Get a pair of clippers. These are Andy's T outliners. Get some clipper spray. It disinfects and it also cleans your clipper. Just brush down your edges. Get into it. So you saw me prep my hairline by brushing down my edges and the corners of my hair. What you see right now is just a fast forward of what I was doing to trim my hair or give myself a lineup. I started from the middle of my forehead, then I went to one side, did the bars. That's what you see, just saw right there, the vertical line. Then I try to do a C cup by using the edge of the clipper and just hit the bottom line, then make that C shape to have that outline come out perfectly. So I did that a couple times, hit that line a couple times to make sure that it looks pretty good. So I'm repeating the same step. So I'm going, starting from the middle and going to one side. Then I'm gonna do this move in a second, which will be the vertical bars as you see just now. Then I hit the bottom line of that box to make it stand out. Then I try to do that C cup. You can see the definition of that line. So I repeat that step a couple times to make sure it looks good. After I do this line up with the clipper, I'm going with the razor to make sure it looks professional or looks as good as possible. So to hit the back of my head, it was difficult as hell. However, I think I did a good job. I could not see for the life of me because I didn't have a handheld mirror. I was trying to use my phone's camera to be a reflection, but that was not working out and it was basically hell. But you know, as you will see in the next clip, it comes out pretty well. Okay, so the best way I find to line up the back of my head was to use my phone's front facing camera and the iPad's front facing camera to get a perfect angle to see back there. But what I'm doing right here is just getting as close as possible to the hair on the back of my head and just hitting that line so it can stand out in comparison to the rest of my hair on my head. Okay, after I hit the sides of my head, I had to clean up the back because the back was looking real reckless and out of pocket. But basically I just had to just hit it a little bit below where my hair like got lighter in comparison to like the dark hair. So I just hit it just a little bit. I'm not gonna lie, I could have did a better job if I had a handheld mirror, but this is the best that I was going to do. I brushed it down to see what I was looking at, and I just tidied it up just a tad more. So that's basically how I did the back of my head. Okay, so I washed and conditioned my hair with the same conditioners and shampoo as my last hair video. So after I did that, as you see right now, I detangled my part and I applied conditioner, a leave-in conditioner, and I applied some castor oil to lock in that moisture, and I twisted my hair clockwise because that's how my hair grows, and I recommend doing that just to help out your curl pattern. You do not have to twist your hair clockwise. It depends on what hair pattern that you have. So find that out and twist your hair according to that information that you found out. So basically I'm just repeating these steps
all throughout my hair. This process could have been so much simpler if I just had some rubber bands or just having my hair stretched. As I previously mentioned, I typically do my twists on stretched hair, but I didn't bring my steamer and I did not bring my blow dryer, so I just had to tough it out and do it on my wet natural hair. So I just repeat these steps over and over again, and I'll tune back in with you guys when a challenging, difficult part comes up. Okay, so the difficult slash challenging part about twisting my hair, or just how I feel about doing my hair in general, it is just the dedication to getting the part straight and not giving up halfway through and having half your head twisted up and the half just an afro. I could have made this process much easier if I just sectioned my hair out and just like put my hair into four parts and just tackle them one at a time, but I had to tackle my hair half at a time because I did not have extra rubber bands or extra headbands, so I just had to tough it out. So as you can see right here, I did half of my hair just straight back, and I pulled the twist towards the side so it hangs down or it lays down correctly. You don't want to have twist or standing up because you're gonna look crazy or look like alfalfa or whatever. But I just repeated the same process and I just took my time. I put on a podcast and I watched the episode of one of my favorite animes. I'll talk to you about that later. But I just repeated the same steps and just tackled it the same way I tackled the right side of my head. Not gonna lie to you, twisting my hair should not have taken so long. Probably because I haven't done my hair by myself in so long. But honestly, if you just put the time out or take the time out your day to just do your own styles, I promise you, you won't regret it. So stay tuned for the final look. Okay, so this is how it turned out. So my hair is still long, but it shrunk up, and this is how it looks for me looking at you straight on. This is how it looks from the side, the other side. I am not really proud of my twisting skills in the back of my head, but I am not gonna cap to y'all, so I'm gonna show you how it looks. It kind of looked crazy, however, not many times people are gonna be looking in the back of my head, so it don't really matter in the grand scheme of things. I forgot to mention the products that I use. I use a Cantu leave-in conditioner, and I use mango and lime Jamaican castor oil. I typically use for my styles is just beeswax and a regular like curl enhanced smoothie, or just a mixed chicks curl cream or something like that. I'm not a chick, but that product would really be going crazy. But with that being said, I think I covered everything that I wanted to cover, from my starting from a braid out to get myself a lineup to washing my hair to twisting my hair, and this is the final result of me all that. Yeah, so with that being said, thanks for tuning in, thanks for checking out this video. If you like this video, smash that like button. If you're new, subscribe to the channel. Let's build up this channel and let's get the ball rolling. I'm not too far off away from 100 subscribers, and it would be greatly appreciated if you smash that subscribe button. But with all that out the way, this has been Norman Reed signing off.